Home Assistant 2022.12 is released and is full of new features. Let's have a quick look at what is new. Home Assistant releases a new version on the first Wednesday of every month. This time it's version 2022.12. Let's see what's in it this time. The first iteration of the Meta integration is released with this version. It's hard to get Meta devices at the moment, but if you have one, you can commission it using the iOS and Android Home Assistant companion apps as of now. The Tile Card was introduced in the previous version and it's extended with features now. This means that if you create a tile card, you can select some features if the tile card shows a vacuum cleaner, light or cover. Next to that, the tile card also got colors now. Based on the state of the entity, the color of the tile icon changes. You can also change the icon colors to your liking. Home Assistant now got a local built-in calendar. You can add the local calendar by going to Settings, Devices and Services, click Add Integration and search for Local Calendar. After that, you will see a new calendar link in the sidebar menu. When you click it, it will show you a list of all your local calendars. You can add events to the calendar just like you can with other calendars that you're already familiar with. I couldn't edit an existing event yet. It would be great if that will be possible too. All in all, it's definitely a great addition to Home Assistant. I will create a tutorial video in the near future on how to work with calendars in Home Assistant. Subscribe to my channel and tick the notification bell so that you won't miss it. If you have second generation Shelly devices in your house that supports Bluetooth, you can now use them as Bluetooth proxies to extend the Bluetooth range in your house. It's a really cool feature that helps to cover your whole house's Bluetooth range. A new entity called Text is included in this release. It's similar to the Text Helper, but this entity is provided by integrations. So, integrations can now ask you to enter a text line in the UI of the integration. This is not something that you can use yourself as a helper, but it comes in handy for developers of integrations. Remember the time that we had to create a template to some entities? It's not that hard to do once you do know how to create templates. But now you do not need templates anymore for this. By the way, if you like to learn how templates work, watch this video that explains this. With the Combine the State of Several Sensors helper, you can now select multiple entities and sum them too. Actually, the Min-Max helper is now renamed to Combine the State of Several Sensors, so the other functions of the old Min-Max helper are also in there. Then the other changes in this release. When you install this release, it will let you know that you have to enter a country code. Twinkly is now supported as well, so get your Twinkly Christmas decoration and control it with Home Assistant this Christmas. The new Acara Pet Feeder C1 is now supported by ZHA. The humidifier card now has on and off controls too, and Alexa supports humidifiers now too. BT Home version 2 is released and Home Assistant supports it too. And if you use Picnic for your groceries, you can add products to your order using Home Assistant. There are also some new integrations now like AirQ, Aranet, Livisi Smart Home, RuviTag BLE and Sensirion BLE. Before you install this release, do check the breaking changes in this list. In my case, an automation didn't work anymore because of the breaking change in Logitech Harmony Hub. Check this list if it affects your own setup. So, this was a quick sum up of the Home Assistant 2022.12 release. I hope you like the new things that are developed in the past month. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.